Hey everyone, this is Mohith from Thennika Creations and a very happy new year to everyone around the world. Welcome to a brand new Fusion tutorial, and today we'll be creating this text effect. This is my first tutorial using Fusion 9, very late, I know. Before we start, if you end up liking this video, please do support the channel, give this video a thumbs up, hit that subscribe button and the bell icon. Okay, so let's get started. First of all, I'm going to set the time frame to 90 frames. Then I'm going to add a background node. Drag it to the viewer, click fit. Next, add a text plus node. Let's type in the text modern. Go to the shading tab. Change the color. Set the value to 0.2. For this entire animation, we need three texts, so I'm going to copy this text plus node. Paste it twice, that is Ctrl C to copy and Ctrl V to paste. So we have three text plus nodes. Let's replace the text in the second text plus node as clean, and the third will be design. Let's connect the output of the second text to the first. A merge node is added, and then let's connect this to the merge node. Drag this merge to the second viewer. Connect the second merge and the black background. You can see the texts are overlapping. We need all the three texts at different heights. So select text 1. Go to layout. Change the Y value for the center to 0.65. Then select the third. Go to the layout, change the Y value to 0.35. Next, we need to add the white rectangle, and that will add in between these two nodes. So I'm going to select these nodes and drag it down. And then let's add a background node. Add a rectangle mask to the new background. In the properties window, let's change the height to 0.12 and the width to 0.35. Let's drag it to this viewer. We need to change the color. Make it white. Now connect the output of this to this and connect the output of the new merge to the foreground input here. This is exactly as expected. So I need the rectangle to start over from here. So I'm going to select the rectangle and set the Y value of the center to 0.65, which matches with the modern text node. Let's now animate this rectangle. So we want the rectangle to scale up in width, move down, and then further down. So with this rectangle selected, go to frame 16, set a keyframe for the width, and then move to frame 0 and bring the value down to 0. Let's play it now. Well, the animation is really boring, so let's go into the spline editor. And here I'm going to show you a trick that I use to make the animation look smooth and energetic. So click on this to fit, click inside the graph editor, and then press Ctrl A on the keyboard to select all the keyframes. Press F to flatten the keyframe handles. Go to frame 8 and press K on the keyboard to add a keyframe along the curve in the spline editor. Now this 8th frame is right in the middle between the two keyframes. Since the animation is starting at frame 0 and it goes on till 16, we have 8 frames till here and 8 frames from here. So here's a trick. Select this handle and pull over till here. That is one frame distance from here. I'm going to make sure that this handle is in line with this keyframe. Do the same thing with this handle, make sure that it is in line with this keyframe. Let's check our animation now. It's better, but it can be snappier. I want it to ease into this region. So I'm going to move this keyframe 3 frames back. So 1, 2, 3. So now I have to adjust the handle again. Match it with this keyframe. Do the same thing here. I want it to ease into this region. So select this keyframe and press T on the keyboard. Click on lock in and out, then set the value to 85. Let's play it now. Yeah, that looks good. So let's go 10 frames forward at 26. I'm going to animate the center values. We'll be animating in the Y axis. Normally we right click on the center and click animate. And then if we go into the spline editor, we have only one parameter called displacement to control both X and Y, which is not ideal in most cases. So I'll press Ctrl Z to undo all of that. And instead I'll right click, ignore the animate and then move to modify with XY path. Let's go to the spline editor and we now have separate parameters for X and Y, which is great. For now, I'm just bothered about Y, so I'm going to off X and width. Click on fit, then go to 36. We need to bring it down, so set the Y value to 0.5. We'll do the same thing that we did earlier in the spline editor. Click inside. Ctrl A to select both the keyframes and then press F to flat. Then go to frame 31 and press K to add a keyframe. Then select the handle and place it there. Adjust this handle also in position. To match this keyframe. Let's check the animation. Okay, next we want the rectangle to hold its position for 10 frames. At 46, let's set a key by double clicking this vertical rectangle. Again, move 10 frames to 56. Let's bring it further down. So set the Y value to 0.35. Okay. Yeah, but if we click on fit, this whole thing will be fit into this region, but we just need this portion. So I'm going to click on the zoom button here and box select this region. So we have our intended keyframes fit into this region. Now click inside, Ctrl A to select the keyframes. We'll need to box select the keyframes and press F to flat. If we press Ctrl A, it will select all the keyframes, whereas we need just these two. So box select it, then go to frame 51, press K to add the keyframe and adjust the handles like so. And this one over here. Yeah. Go back to the flow and press play. So far so good, let's complete the animation. Select the rectangle and go 10 frames forward at 66. Set a key for width and then around frame 80, set the width to 0. Go to the spline editor and let's uncheck Y and click on the width. I'm going to use this one. Click and drag to zoom into this region. Do not press Ctrl A, instead we'll box select these two keyframes. So click and drag, press F to flat, go to frame 73. Press K to add a keyframe. Adjust the handle like so. Do the adjustment here as well. Actually, I need the animation to be snappy, so let's move 2 frames backwards. Set the value of this handle to 85. And adjust this handle. It's gone below the key, so drag it up like so. and adjust this one too. So let's see what we have now. Press play. Great, I'm happy with the animation. I also want the text to appear relative to the rectangle. So connect the output of this rectangle to the mask input of this text. Right now, if we play the animation, the rectangle is affecting just the modern, but we'll also need it to affect the other two texts as well. So let's connect the output of the rectangle to this text and this one as well. So let's play it, see what we have. Looks good, but we obviously need to work on the color transitions of the text. As the rectangle moves down, I need the modern to not disappear as it is now, but change its color to white. And when the rectangle goes to design, both modern and clean should stay white. So I'm going to select all these nodes and move it down. Then I'll select these two texts, Ctrl C to copy and Ctrl V to paste it over here. Let's select this modern. So connect the output of this to this. Adjust the new merge. Then connect the output of this to this, like so. Now let's select this text node and change its color. Go to shading, make it white. Do the same thing for this one too. Shading, white. We still need to do some work. Anyways, let's play to see what we have. Not the desired result. We need gray to white color transition, which is not happening yet. For that, we need to use the same rectangle mask, but if we simply connect the rectangle mask to the mask input of these text nodes, and if we play, well, not what we are looking for. So I'll copy this rectangle and paste it here. Then let's connect it to these text nodes. There. But it's exactly what we did earlier, so select this rectangle and invert it by clicking on invert. Let's play it now. Well, we have achieved the color transitions as expected. But the modern and clean is visible all the time as you see. We need to get rid of that. Select this merge, so around 26, let's set the blend value to 0, set a key, go to frame 27, set the value to 1. So with that, we have solved the issue of modern showing up early. And go to frame 46, select this merge, set the blend value to 0, set the key, and at 47, increase it to 1. Let's play the animation. Good, I'm happy with it. Okay, I just want to tweak the animation a little bit. So select these two rectangles, then go to the spline editor, fit, and I just want the width selected. I don't need these. Click on select. I don't need these and these, just the width of those two. Then select everything over here and fit. Let's click on this button till it reaches time offset and set the value to 10 to move the keyframes 10 frames forward. We'll also need the modern and clean to move downwards behind design and disappear. So I'm going to select this one and this one, go to 66. At 66, let's go to layout. At center, right click and go to modify with XY path. Go to, actually it's applied only for this one. Select the second one, go to layout, right click, modify with XY path. Then go to like 80, set the value to 0.35 and this one also to 0.35. Go to the spline editor, just select Y. Click inside the graph editor, Ctrl A, press F to flat. Move to 73 and press K to add a keyframe. Let's do the same thing, adjust the handles like so. Select this one and do the same thing. Get rid of X, fit, Ctrl A, F to flat. Press K to add the keyframe and adjust the handles. This one too. Let's check what we have. Okay, I'm going to give this an offset and go to spline editor. Select all of that. Then press Ctrl A and then set an offset of 2 frames. Let's see now. Okay, now we need it to disappear behind design. So, at frame 80, select Merge 5 and set a key for Blend and at 81, make it 0. Select Merge 6 and at 80, set a key. And at 81, make it 0. Let's play it now. Okay, so that is what we have. A little bit of overlap there, which I don't like. So select this text, go to the spline editor and move the keyframes backwards. We had moved it 2 frames forward earlier, so we'll move it 4 frames backward now. Set it to minus 4. Play it now. Yeah, that looks really, really good. If you have any doubts about something that was shown in this video, drop a comment below. I'll get to it as soon as I can. So that's it for this video, guys. If you like it, give it a huge thumbs up. And for further tutorials like these, hit that subscribe button if you haven't yet. If you're already subscribed, hit that bell icon so that you get notified every time there's a new upload on this channel at Thennika Creations. Share this video if you feel someone in your circles could benefit from this video. Thanks a lot for watching. This is Mohith signing off and I'll see you in the next video. And you guys have a great day. Bye-bye.